Okay, so moving on from Middlewich, first lock of the day is King's Lock, which will take us down into the basin where the junction for the Wardall and the Middlewich arm is. And then there's a flight of three locks, which hopefully there's going to be some volunteers at. Well, I don't know if you caught that beeping noise when I came into this lock landing, but there's a guy fishing there, right on the lock landing. And obviously he's got some sort of alarm on his lines that tells him if the fish is biting. Thing is, the boat disturbed it, and he's been sat there all night. Anyway, into King's Lock, with the King's Lock pub on the right hand side there. Sure. Well, that's handy. There's somebody waiting to use the lock, and they're going to do it for me. So immediately over to the left is the Middlewich arm, but there's 35 metres of it, which is the Wardall canal, just 35 metres. Little canal this at Middlewich. Narrow boats either side, higher boats go from here as well. Literally just go through here at a snail's pace in case a boat comes the other way. Sure enough, there's a boat coming the other way. So we're coming up to the first of the three which are on a flight. It's a holiday boat that's just come out, that one. People on that boat.
Hiya.
on that boat. It's cozy, isn't it? So this is the top lock of the three. And there's an acute left-hand bend immediately after the lock that goes into the next lock. Well, I'm glad the gates are opening because I'm getting wet from the water coming in from the lock gates behind me. This is the acute left-hand bend I was on about, and there's a boat coming out the other lock. He's cheating, he's using his bell thrusters.
Really?
Yeah. I try not to use them, the skills in not using them. Interesting little turn. I'm really pleased there's volunteers here. So that would be interesting doing it on your own. I should think somebody needs to volunteer for him. Hello. It's pretty amazing when you're in this lock. That's a long way down to the next level. Thanks very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. This is the Anderton boat hire yard immediately below the third lock. When we walked this yesterday, there were loads more boats than this here, so they obviously had a low ground on hire. But there's still 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. They've still got 9 boats sitting here that are not out on hire. That's a lot of money tied up just sitting there. No wonder hiring a narrowboat is so expensive. They've got to pay capital costs on idle machinery. That's without all the other overheads that are incurred. And there's a sign for the narrowboat inn, which is currently all closed up and to let. Okay, so we're coming up to a water point on the left hand side here, which is the old wharf buildings, and the house was the offices for the Mersey and Trent Canal. All laying idle. Pigeon City. There's one on a nest there. So we're coming up to what they call the big lock, because it is a double width lock. And the big lock hub is right next to it.
Dangerous, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why doesn't it say that on there?
What? I don't know. write to the publisher. So it's literally single boat width, aqueduct, going over a river. So the River Dane here on the bend, wide expanse of water. Where it actually says danger shallow water, do not enter. So if you went in there, you'd get ground out. Yeah. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Swan got a couple of new additions to the family. Bridges have got a different shape here, they're not arched. Cuttings, and it is a visitor mooring, 48 hour mooring. Oh. It's a nice spot, but my god, there's a lot of trees there. Trees. Don't think I'll bother with that. Too many trees. Bramble cuttings. What's the story with the rail line, I wonder? There's two of them. It's high in the bow. Sally and Sweet Caroline. Well, because it narrows down, I had to be on this side. Thank you. Yeah, interesting.
Is that why they call it Murder Bridge?
Oh, do they?
Yes.
Thank you.
Take it easy. You and me both.
Always meet boats in the narrowest point. Strange, isn't it? Hello. There's lots of branches down across the canal at this point. Narrows it down if you meet somebody else coming the other way. Yeah, literally just one room for one boat. Be interesting to see if we meet anybody up through here then, because it is literally just one width of a boat. I think there are more actually. Away with that then, nothing coming. Very nice property up in there. Tight bend. Are those ducks all lined up in a row? Asleep, some of them. Well, they're asleep soon. All right.
Oh, yeah, right. They're asleep soon, yeah.
Right, hang on, Chris. too fast and they've gone into the wall. It's been a really interesting day today. We set off from Middlewich and did the flight of locks there, and then moored up and did a shop at Lidl, which is about a 15 minute walk from the canal, which is very handy, and then continued on down towards the Anderton boat lift. I guess we're, I don't know, probably 6 miles away from Anderton boat lift at the moment, in a very rural secluded spot. Got a nice sunny afternoon, which is quite a contrast to some of the day, which has been pouring with rain. So yeah, it's all good. And it's surprising how many boats are up and down this stretch of canal. And on a couple of blind corners today, we did meet some boats and had to do some fast evasive action. All very interesting. So from a very sunny rural scene on the Trent Mersey Canal, about 6 miles from Anderton boat lift, it's good night. Gonna enjoy the sunshine now. Bye.